So, we've seen ED25519. One question that might come up is, why did we go through the effort of doing it with an Edwards curve? Why didn't we just use the Montgomery curve? And that's a good question. So, I want to make a quick comparison between Montgomery curves and twisted Edwards curves. So, Montgomery curves have a very fast constant time scalar multiplication using the Montgomery ladder. They can use exact arithmetic very efficiently with the Montgomery ladder and the curve equations, and they're very fast for variable base scalar multiplication. That is, you have a base point that can be different. It's not always the same. It's different for every instantiation, let's say, every time you call the functions, and there it's very fast. And it's of course used quite a lot in Diffie-Hellman. Now, twisted Edwards curves, on the other hand, they have a complete addition law, which is nice. We don't have to deal with points at infinity or addition and doubling. We can just use one equation for everything. It's quite nice. And they're very fast for fixed-based scalar multiplication. That is, you have one fixed base, usually a generator from a standard, and that can be, with tricks, implemented very fast. So it's better for signing, where we have a standardized generator that we always need to compute with. And we can actually do some pretty fast non-constant time implementations with Edwards curves. Now, we never want non-constant time implementations because then we get side channel leaks again, right? Then we can maybe via timing identify secret scalars. Well, but we can use non-constant time code in verification because in verification we exclusively use public information, so we don't worry about side channels. So, in conclusion, Montgomery curves are better for elliptic curve Diffie-Hellman, for variable base scalar multiplication, and twisted Edwards curves are better for signature schemes because they can be faster in fixed-based scalar multiplication.